Hi, welcome to Community Connect. Here I have with me Karen Reenders, Executive Director of the People Center. Thank you for being here today.
Thank you for having me.
So tell me a little bit about the People Center.
The People Center is located in Spring Lake. We provide food and clothing for families in need, and we also have transitional housing where we can house people who face housing crisis. We are located right near the library in Spring Lake here, right on Savage, is where our campus is.
And did I see some raised garden beds there?
We have raised garden beds. Right now we have a young Girl Scout that is taking care of those gardens. This will be her third summer taking care of those gardens, and all the produce goes to any family in need.
Okay, and then how do those families kind of connect with the People Center to receive those?
They come to the food pantry. They can come up to four times a year, and it has to be 30 days between visits, and it can be anybody from the Tri-Cities and smaller surrounding communities can come to use our People Center food pantry.
So unlike the food truck that comes like to St. Pat's, you guys have a dedicated food pantry.
We do.
And how do people donate to that?
A lot of times they can drop food off anytime, and we get it if they put it on our back steps. And we also, we are open Monday, Wednesday, and Friday from 11 to 5. They can drop off food at that time.
And is it any type of non-perishable items?
Non-perishable items that is not expired.
Okay.
So, and a huge benefit to the People Center is the Postal Workers Food Drive, which happens May 11. And that's just, it fills our pantry and gets us through the summer. It's amazing.
Sure. Yeah. And then basically what you do, if people aren't familiar, you leave the food on your doorstep and then the mail carriers will pick it up.
Yep. Yep. And we have volunteers that help sort all that day and everything like that.
Yeah. So. Amazing. So tell me a little bit about some of the other things that you do for the city.
We also have clothing there. And so when the families come in to get food, we are the only place in the community that gives away clothing. So they are welcome to come and take clothing for themselves and their immediate family that live in their household. And we have the whole basement of the house that we're in is set up like a clothing store, men's, women's, children's departments. And we have interview clothing if somebody needs a suit or women need something fancy to go to job interviews. We have all of those types of clothing too.
Is there like an interview process that they need to go through to see if they qualify for your assistance?
For food and clothing, it is just a valid picture ID that says where they live. Mm-hmm. And then we limit how many times a year they come. And then, but for our housing program, it is application based. I have to have an opening big enough to fit them.
Sure.
And they have to be working full time in order to get an application.
So tell me a little bit about the housing program. How does that, so once somebody has gone through the application process, they're approved, how do you, or where do you find your homes?
We have six apartments right there on our campus, right by our food pantry. We own the two big white houses on Savage Street, and then the little gray house where the food pantry is has an apartment upstairs. And they can live there up to 6 months, and it's rent utility free, but they must be working full time in order to be there. And they are enrolled at the Financial Empowerment Center through the City of Grand Haven, Grand Haven's Neighborhood Housing Services.
Okay, and that's right downtown.
That's right downtown Grand Haven.
Is it like the old fire barn still?
Yes, it is.
Sure.
And they kind of work with them with their financials, and we get them either rental ready or mortgage ready so that somebody in the community will rent to them, or maybe they can even take out a mortgage and purchase a home.
So in the hopes after the 6 months, they're not finding another transitional house.
But, correct.
You know, with the financial planning and guidance from professionals, they're ready to purchase or rent.
Correct.
That's great.
Yep.
Are there any other programs that kind of really stick out and really help the community?
What we do is when the families are there, if we find they have other needs, we refer them to who does it best. For instance, Tri-Cities Ministries for counseling if that's what they need, mental health counseling if that's what they need. Just we refer those types of things away and let the people who do it well do it.
Good. Can you give me a success story of a family that came in and they
really need,
I'm sure there are tons of them, but.
There are, but the newest one, she just moved out last week and she was going through divorce and had debt, almost 30 grand in debt, and was not rental ready or mortgage ready. Nobody would rent to her because her debt ratio to income ratio was so extreme.
And it may not have been her fault, but that was a situation she was in at this point.
And so we worked with her and she was able to pay down all but $7,000 of that debt.
Wow.
And it was all credit card debt. And so the two credit cards that she had left, she will be able to have zero interest because she called them and worked with them. And mm-hmm. so she's just going to make payments, and in 3 years she'll have those both paid off. And Great. She became rental ready and moved into a rental unit.
Wow.
She was amazing. She wanted to do it right, and she mm-hmm. did it right.
Yeah. So get another chance.
Yep.
Perfect.
So we really look at their financial well-being and try to get them financially healthy. Mm-hmm. If there's a lot of mental health issues, sometimes we're not so successful. Unless they're getting the proper care. Mm-hmm. And so we really are looking at somebody who needs to get financially healthy, and we work with them to do that. That's with great. Their own money.
Sure. And tell me about, what can you do for the kids that are part of the family as well?
Typically, we can provide counseling through Tri-Cities Ministries, but I don't work so much with the kids, but they do better when they are at the People Center. They do better at school.
Stability.
Mm-hmm. They you know, they get that. They can use our food pantry when they're living there, so that is helpful to the parents.
You've got to have full bellies for
yes.
the kids for
yes.
them to succeed in school.
A bed,
be
a warm,
happy.
Comfortable bed at night, and they just do better
going.
during school.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Amazing.
Yeah.
Good. So tell me about, how can people get involved, whether they need assistance or whether somebody, you know, has a heart for what you guys are doing and they want to volunteer time or have some.
We have
funds.
Volunteer opportunities. Our open hours are manned by all volunteers. I have a pool of over 65 volunteers wow. that man our open hours, and they ebb and flow as well. So we're always looking for somebody to fill those mm-hmm. spaces. That's during the open hours, during Monday, Wednesday, Friday between 11 and 5. So they can just give me a call at the People Center, and we can set them up for a little training. It's not much. They're just helping people get food and clothing. And then if they are interested in gardening, yard work, yard maintenance, mm-hmm. I'm always looking for a handy person who can help me fix things, because 6 apartments plus the office is a lot of little repair
sure.
jobs, and so I'm always looking for somebody to do that.
So it really doesn't matter if you're a teenager that likes to work in the yard, or if you're a handyman that can fix things, or you know, maybe even a grandma that likes to do her gardening
yep.
or sewing
yep.
or things like that.
Yep.
Yeah.
And then as far as clients go, you don't need to make an appointment to use our food and clothing. You can just show up during our open hours. Sometimes you might have to wait if other people are there. It's a first come, first serve on the days we're open. And for the apartments, you must call me first and set up a time for an application, because I don't always have openings, because mm-hmm. 6 apartments fill pretty quickly.
For sure. Yeah. So we talked about if folks want to donate food, how they can do that. But what about clothing?
Clothing, the same thing. They can drop off clothing during our open hours, or we have a box on the back porch where they can put them in there.
And what are some future projects that you guys are working on?
Right now, we don't have anything in the works. Our food pantry is a little small, so we've toyed around with maybe expanding the food pantry, but it's in the very infant stages of that idea.
Okay.
But otherwise, we like to do what we do, and we do it well, so we continue to do
Great.
It.
Right. And what can the community do to maybe help these dreams come true of a larger food pantry?
Donations would be
okay.
nice. Would be very nice.
Just keep those stocks.
Yes, yep.
Sure. Okay. Anything else that you want to add?
I don't think so.
All right. Well, thank you for being on the show. I really appreciate it. It's
thank
great
you for
to
having
about
me.
The People Center and what you guys do for the community.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thanks for watching Community Connect. We'll see you next time.
Dreaming of buying a home? Your local Lakeshore lending team, Envoy Mortgage, is ready to assist you. Call Casey or William at 616-303-0728. Love your home, love your loan.
D. Baker & Son Lumber Company has been connecting with the Tri-Cities since 1871. Our traditions haven't changed in all these years. Quality products, honest pricing, and partnerships with local suppliers is why D. Baker & Son Lumber Company stands the test of time.